This startup has made it to the list of Forbes 30 Under 30 Asia this year. So we're going to find out more about Quick Commerce and Astro, its challenges, and as well as their achievements. We are now with Sherlyn Gautama. Good morning.
Morning.
Morning, Sherlyn.
Morning.
Thank you for joining us this morning.
Yeah, happy to be here.
All right. So before we get into talking about the recent achievement, Forbes 30 Under 30 Asia, tell us a little bit about Astro and Quick Commerce.
Right, so Astro and Quick Commerce, we're basically an e-commerce. We deliver groceries, but at a very rapid speed of 15 minutes delivery.
Wow.
That's it. That's like as simple as it gets, okay. The business, right?
So it's generally the e-commerce we're used to, like Kai said, but get right to our door in about 15 minutes that we've ordered it.
Exactly.
That's unbelievable.
Yep. Right.
I can't get anywhere in Jakarta in 15
minutes. That's what we need,
right? Exactly. So tell us a little bit about this award that you recently have gotten. You got on the list of Forbes 30 Under 30.
Yeah.
What does this achievement indicate, and what does it mean for you and your company?
Yeah, I think it came as a pleasant surprise, for sure, right? I mean, I knew we were nominated by our, you know, very supportive investors for Forbes 30 Under 30 Indonesia. And honestly, I think one day, Vincent actually, our CEO, he actually got a text from the Forbes 30 Under 30 Indonesians team, mm-hmm. saying like, hey Vincent, you know, can you tell Sherlyn and Marcella to actually check their email? Because, you know, because I think we texted them quite a few days ago, but have yet to get a response.
Right.
We need them to come down for like a photo shoot with the rest of the nominees. And then he told us, and then I guess me and Marcella was just like, wait, what? We didn't get an email, you know? And it turns out it was in our junk mail.
The spam.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Happens to me all the time. So, yeah.
Happens to me all the time, right?
Exactly. So at that time, we got on with it, right? We got a photo shoot with like all the other nominees for the Indonesian the awards. And then I guess like a month or about 2 months later, one morning I woke up and then we just got an email saying like, hey, you got nominated for Forbes 30 Under 30 Asia too. You got
wow.
in. And then Marcella and I were just like, I remember, I think in a couple of minutes, we just texted like, did we really get in? Like, are we in? Like, yeah, we're in. And then we're like, oh, okay, I guess like, I think it's something exciting. It means a lot for us also, definitely. I think for the team too, for the bigger Astro team, they were very happy, very excited for us. I think that at that time, we were only about, I guess, like 4 or 5 months in from when we started.
Wow.
So I think that it meant a lot for us because I think a lot more people got to know what Astro was about. People know like, oh, what is this and what is Astro actually trying to build in Indonesia?
Yeah, yeah. And I guess it's just an indicator. Not only are you recognized, I mean, it's a big recognition to get this sort of achievement in Indonesia alone, but that you're recognized in the region as well. I'm sure you're up against some very tough competition.
Yeah, exactly. I think it definitely helped us. Definitely helped us in hiring. A lot more people actually reached out, telling us like, hey, they want to be a part of the Astro team. And I'm glad. I'm glad that this award has helped the business in that way because hiring is tough.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, we've mentioned before that was a large investment sum as well. And how did you two have the idea to start Quick Commerce? Where were you first exposed to Quick Commerce, and how did you have the idea of implementing Quick Commerce in the Indonesian market as well?
Right, so the five of us, I guess we sort of knew one another even before we started Astro together, right? From like mutual friends or some sort of that. And at the beginning, I think we were always exploring the groceries or like the F&B industry, just because I think that was an industry that is close to our hearts for the five of us.
Okay.
At the beginning, we were actually thinking of like, what about healthy groceries, right?
Okay.
Because we always wanted to provide something of quality to the people. And when we were just doing like the research and all about that, we kind of found this idea of Quick Commerce, like delivery in 15 minutes. I think at that time, it was a very booming industry overseas in the United States, in Europe. And then we were just thinking like, oh, what if we brought this idea to Indonesia? You know, and then we kind of discussed what it would mean for us personally, in our personal lives, what would it mean for on the business perspective, bringing this new, completely new idea to Jakarta, to Indonesia, right? And then I guess like after, some debates here and there, like, discussing what's the pros, what's the cons, I guess like the five of us were off the same page. We think that, we should take this opportunity. So we took the challenge and we started it, right? I guess it was a bit of, you know, taking the right opportunity at the right time for five of us who were very curious and wanted to try out something new.
Right. So you mentioned pros and cons. Let's take it back a little bit, because as I mentioned, you know, for me, 15 minutes, I cannot imagine I can't travel more than 5 or 10 kilometers in that span
yep.
of time.
Yep.
You obviously did some research. This is a booming thing in Europe, the US, and other countries as well. However, they have different infrastructures, mode of transports.
Definitely.
There are some advantages to having couriers here in Indonesia. A lot of them are motorcycles and they can get place to place a lot easier.
Yeah.
But I can also say there must be a huge challenge being in Jakarta, where there's actually a lot of traffic as well.
Yeah.
What are some of the challenges that you guys faced when you first started Astro?
Yeah, I guess the challenges that we faced at the beginning, some of it still applies for now.
Mm-hmm.
I think a huge chunk of it would probably be like the supply chain side of things,
oh.
right? I think this is a pretty complex business model. You have a lot of things that you need to take a look at, like making sure the delivery is right, making mm-hmm. sure that the products are of quality when you mm-hmm. send it to the customers
mm-hmm.
and stuff like that. And one of the issues that we face would probably be the hubs that we have, which is what we call, I guess, the dark stores, they are they have limited space. So
okay.
it's not that we can store anything and with a large a quantity of items in the hub, right? And because of that, we have to be pretty selective at what do we have actually listed on the app, right? What kind of items that is like not too big of a volume because it's going to be taking up too much space, and at the same time, it has to be pretty fast paced so that mm-hmm. the supply can actually come in and out very fast.
Plus, you're dealing with fresh stuff a lot of times, so
they
have like an expiry date a lot of times.
Yeah,
as well,
that's right. That's right. And even if like, you know, some stuff like probably let's say like diapers, they take mm-hmm. up a lot of space, a lot of volume where you can actually store like maybe other smaller items, right? So we have to be, there's a team obviously who does the research of like what items actually moves in and out fast enough for us to replenish that on a daily basis. And also, you know, because of that, there are limited items to what, I mean, we can sell. I mean, we do have most of the items that you can find in a supermarket.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But when the difference between us, I guess, and like a normal e-commerce would be that it's probably difficult for you to send like bulkier, heavier items.
Right.
Like you can't expect to order like a TV or like a table or like a fridge like
in 15
and get it delivered in 15
That's
minutes.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think a lot of times this is going to be more for convenience, because immediately Kai and I can relate to this, because there
as
are times
mobile family.
We do groceries,
yeah.
we have little ones in the house, but then it's like, oh, I forgot these two items.
Awesome.
And I think this is where it can come in really handy, because sometimes those two items are needed to make our next meal, for example.
Yeah. Yes, these are the that's
times,
right.
Yeah. And sometimes you don't have the time to have to get into the car and then get out of the house and then buy the groceries and then come back again.
Yeah, sometimes it takes more time.
Exactly.
That takes more
exactly.
time.
And there's also commerce services that you can rely on, instant deliveries, where you have to actually rely on the courier themselves to select items, and that not be they may not be part of their job description. They might be like, oh, you want me to pick a ripe avocado? Like, I don't know how to do that. I barely know how to do that.
Yes,
right? So that's
exactly.
It's nice that you've actually put quality. I think is an important factor that
for sure.
you guys have in your.
So just out of curiosity, because Jakarta and the greater area, right, is a very extensive network. Out of curiosity, how many dark warehouses or dark houses do you guys have to make sure that you can, you know, you can deliver the deliveries within 15 minutes amount of time? I mean, like 15 minutes is probably like from here to Kuningan.
Yeah, in this
right?
part, yeah.
That's
on
like
a good
from
day.
Here to
on a good day.
That's right. So talk to us about how you guys manage to plan the right dark rooms at the right spots, and how many of those in total are you guys operating right now?
Right. Obviously, at the beginning, it was a little bit of like test and trial, right? We have to see, I mean, we tried to find like the best location, and then we actually have to launch it, have to actually execute it to see, oh, is that the right place we can have to actually cover like the maximum amount of people in that area. Currently, we have like approximately around 50 dark stores. We're still growing, still figuring out, I guess, like the best place to put our warehouse in so that we can reach the right people, you know, in the right area. So yeah, currently we have 50. We have three main bigger warehouses. I think those warehouses are for storing most of the items
mm-hmm.
that we get from the vendors and stuff like that. And this warehouse is where you actually, we do like a daily supply to these mini stores, which is what you call the dark stores.
Okay.
And when customer orders, it's delivered from the dark store, not from the warehouse.
Right. Okay, so you mentioned supply chains. You've also worked directly with farmers. Is that correct? Can you tell us a little bit more?
Yeah, we started that with, our fresh products, like the vegetables and the fruits.
Right.
And maybe some of you have heard, around 2-3 months ago, we launched what we call our private label.
Okay.
So it's basically products with Astro's own branding, right? So we try to source, like, for example, it was the coffee that we had. We had like coffees, we had some breads ongoing. The concept was like more for breakfast where people, you know, we hope that people can just wake up in the morning or if they want to go to work, they can just grab and go with this coffee and this bread, right? That's the concept.
So
this coffee that we made, we source these beans from our local farmers through our vendors. We work with them and hoping that, you know, with this quality beans, we can provide like quality products that our customers can actually consume on a daily basis. And actually, we have just a small teaser. We have like a new product launching in the next couple of months. So stay tuned to that.
So your products, your own products are listed in there as well, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
That is in our app.
Just curious, can I use this at any time of the day?
Yeah, it's 24 hours.
Wow.
Okay. 24 hours.
There's already another plus.
Baby wakes up at 2 o'clock in the morning. There's a possibility to get a formula.
You'll be surprised at things I need at 3 a.m. sometimes.
Yes, me too. I'm surprised at the things that I need now. I require now with kids and everything. But, being on the, let's go back to the Forbes, 30 under 30 list. Being on that list means you're not just young, but you're impactful to the society as well. How do you think has Astro grown and since you started, and how much impact are you seeing? Impact-wise, as in how much growth, as in customer-wise and market share-wise, are you seeing?
Right. I think we definitely heard from a couple of people that we did shake things up a bit in the groceries industry. But okay. In all honesty, I think we are just getting started. We're not even a year old. I think our anniversary is this September.
Woo!
So anniversary.
It's coming.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think there's still a lot to learn, a lot to grow in this industry, right? We have grown quite a bit since we started in, like you said, in the amount of users that we have, right? Definitely grow at quite an unbelievable, a bit overwhelming kind of speed, but I think it's a good overwhelming, right? And, at the beginning when we started, a lot of people were telling us like, I don't think I need 15 minutes delivery. Like, what is it? I think I can, I'm fine waiting. Like,
who said
next...
that?
Who said that? Not a lot.
I know, really?
You wouldn't,
The pandemic has made me even more incapable.
Honestly, I think like 9 out of 10 people that the 5 of us, like friends and family that we asked, actually said that.
Wow.
They said like, I think I can wait for tomorrow. I can wait for like a couple days later, right? And then right now, I have people texting me like, hey, where's my groceries? It's 18 minutes. Like, I'm like, that's not what you said at the beginning.
Right. I think once we have something, we realize how much we need it, then we
exactly,
can't let it go,
exactly.
Right?
So, I do hope that we have, I do believe that we have changed a bit of the customer's behavior, right? Because of all this personal experience touch that I hear from my personal friends and family. But at the end, creating this business, I think we want to provide the customers with like the full top service end to end. That's what we want to hope to achieve at the end. And I think there's, it's only like around 10 months in. We still have a long way to go.
So speaking of growth, Kai mentioned you guys have just received an investment, $27 million. How much is that going to help towards your growth, and where do you plan to grow from here?
Yeah. That was in February. We see our Series A. Actually, we announced our Series B funding back in May. That was $60 million USD.
Wow.
We got that. Obviously, I think it's for us to continue expanding the business and at the same time hire the top talents that can actually help to contribute to the business, right? Hiring is not easy. but I think right now, we all know the market is a bit tough. Like, I think the whole world experienced that. So we're definitely being more careful with how we're spending the money, right? And what it would actually mean for us, like how long it would actually keep us sustainable and to become a profitable company. I think that's the aim at the end of the day. Yeah.
I think that is so important because we've experienced a lot of the startup bubble cases that are happening recently. And I am glad that, because I realize that, in reasons of the whole supply chain that you have to provide and then you're basically in charge of everything. You buy the groceries, you store it in a warehouse, you need the warehouse, and then you also need the couriers to be able to deliver. So basically it's a full control business.
Full control.
So it's not exactly, is not exactly the easiest to plan cash flow-wise and cost-wise. So I appreciate the fact that you are so aware about how the investments will help you guys grow. And I certainly cannot wait to start using the application.
Definitely.
Thank you for coming.
Awesome. What are astronauts, by the way?
Yeah.
Why astronauts?
Yeah, what are astronauts?
Astronauts are actually what we call the team.
Okay.
So we call ourselves astronauts, right? At the beginning, I think we had like multiple names, like how we came up with the name Astro. Mm-hmm. So we had like over, I don't know, like 40, 50 names. Okay. And we were just filtering like what would actually fits us the best. And then we started filtering by, you know, thinking of what values would be the things that we're looking for in our team members, right? And I think words such as fast, bold, adventurous, and like innovative came to our mind. Mm. And when we kind of filter our options, we think like, I think an astronaut would actually fit that kind of qualities. And if we were to call our team members astronauts, then what would we be? And that's how I guess like the name Astro came about.
Real quick though, sorry about my cracked screen. I really have a small phone as well, but there you go. Like this is, we've just recently downloaded it as well. It says, hello, Paul. And right away, I've inputted my home address. It's as simple as that. I can go scroll through, and these are the categories that are available.
Yeah.
The vegetables, groceries.
It's got everything.
I'm seeing a lot of household items as well. Oh, my screen's not working.
Is it hanging? Well, I got it here.
No, it's because it's my phone. But there you go. There's meats. There's proteins. It's separated very simply. Frozen foods. There's even ice cream. My kid's going to love that. So again, very, very convenient. I'm definitely going to start putting this to good use.
Thank you.
Want to know more, just download the app. I believe it's available in the App Store and as well in Google Play Store.
Yes.
All right.
Definitely.
There you go. Sherlyn, congratulations. So cool. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
We wish nothing but the best for Astro and wish much success for you as you approach your first year. Very hard.
Yeah.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
All right. We're up for another short break here. In the meantime, speaking of your phones, don't forget to go to your social media platforms and give us a follow at CTodayNews on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube for all the latest updates. We'll be back after this.